So we've been able, carefully, to ease the national restrictions. And alongside the easing of these national restrictions, we have increasingly taken local action. In May, we shut Western Hospital to new admissions after a cluster of cases there. Earlier this month, we closed two GP surgeries in Enfield and a meat processing factory in Kirklees. And the Welsh Government has closed factories in Anglesey and Wrexham. We've put in place a system to tie together local and national action based on insight provided by the Joint Biosecurity Centre, working closely with Public Health England and the NHS. Analysis is based on three levels of spread. Individual cases are identified and managed by NHS Test and Trace. When many cases are found in one setting, be it a care home, for instance, a factory or a hospital, that is classified as a cluster. And that will be dealt with largely by the local director of public health, who has statutory powers to close individual organisations. When Public Health England or the new JBC identifies clusters that are linked to one another, that is defined as an outbreak. And a range of local and national actions may be needed. Decisions are taken through our local action committee command structure. It works as follows. If PHE or the JBC spots a problem that needs attention, or the local director of public health reports up a problem through the regional health protection teams, then the outbreak is assessed at the daily local action committee bronze meeting. Issues of concern are raised to the local action committee silver meeting, which is chaired by the chief medical officer. And problems requiring ministerial attention and then are raised to the local action committee gold meeting. Yesterday, I chaired an emergency local action committee gold meeting specifically to deal with the outbreak in Leicester. Unfortunately, while cases in most parts of the country have fallen since the peak, in Leicester, they've continued to rise. The seven-day infection rate in Leicester is 135 cases per 100,000 people, which is three times higher than the next highest city. Leicester accounts for around 10% of all positive cases in the country over the past week. And admissions to hospital are between 6 and 10 per day, rather than around 1 a day at other trusts. Over the past fortnight, we've already taken action to protect people in Leicester. We deployed 4 mobile testing units and extra capacity at the regional test site. We provided thousands of home testing kits and extra public health capacity to boost the local team. This afternoon, I held a further meeting with local leaders, with Public Health England, the JBC, the Local Resilience Forum, and my clinical advisors, followed by a meeting of the Cross-Government COVID Operations Committee, chaired by the Prime Minister. We have agreed further measures to tackle the outbreak in Leicester. First, in addition to the mobile testing units that I mentioned earlier, we'll send further testing capability, including opening a walk-in centre. Anyone in Leicester with symptoms must come forward for a test. Second, we will give extra funding to Leicester and Leicestershire councils to support them to enhance their communications and ensure those communications are translated into all locally relevant languages. Third, through the councils, we'll ensure support is available for those who have to self-isolate. And fourth, we'll work with the workplaces that have seen clusters of cases to implement more stringently the COVID secure guidelines. Given the growing outbreak in Leicester, we cannot recommend that the easing of the national lockdown, set to take place on the 4th of July, happens in Leicester. Having taken clinical advice on the actions necessary, and discussed them with the local team in Leicester and Leicestershire, we've made some difficult but important decisions. We've decided that from tomorrow, non-essential retail will have to close. And as children have been particularly impacted by this outbreak, schools will also need to close from Thursday, staying open for vulnerable children and children of critical workers as they did throughout. Unfortunately, the clinical advice is that the relaxation of shielding measures due on the 6th of July cannot now take place in Leicester. We recommend to people in Leicester, stay at home as much as you can. and we recommend against all but essential travel to, from, and within Leicester. We'll monitor closely adherence to social distancing rules, and we'll take further steps if that's what's necessary. The more people follow the rules, the faster we'll get control of this virus and get Leicester back to normal. We'll keep all of these local measures under review, and we will not keep them in place any longer than is necessary. We'll review whether we can release any measures in 2 weeks' time. These Leicester-specific measures will apply not just to the city of Leicester, but also to the surrounding conurbation, including, for example, Oadby, Birstall, and Glenfield. I know that this is a worrying time for people living in Leicester, and I want you to know that you have our full support. We do not take these decisions lightly, but with the interests of the people of Leicester in our hearts. I want everyone in Leicester to know that we've taken every one of these decisions to protect them from this terrible virus. We must control this virus. We must keep people safe. These actions are profoundly in the national interest too, because it's in everyone's interest that we control the virus as locally as possible. Local action like this is an important tool in our armory to deal with outbreaks while we get the country back on our feet. And Mr. Speaker, we said that we do whatever it takes to defeat this virus, and we said that local action would be an increasingly important part of our plan. The virus thrives on social contact, and we know that reducing social contact controls its spread. Precise and targeted actions like these will give the virus nowhere to hide and help us defeat this invisible killer. And I commend this statement to the House.